Hello students, how are you? I hope and wish that you are studying hard for your medical entrance examinations. And the most important thing while studying is what? To keep calm and then study hard. No point in taking faltu ka tension. No point in taking faltu ka load. Usne 10 chapter kar liye, maine 4 hi chapter kare. Nothing matters. Study at your pace. Just study hard with your full potential. Now, let us start our chapter for today, our lecture for today. And the topic that we are continuing is what? Endocrine system. And before I start the class, what I say, please sit in a quiet corner. If possible, sit on a table and chair. And please make notes when I'm talking, when I'm saying, when you're seeing the screen. And please don't get distracted on your own and, you know, pause the YouTube and just go and see some songs on YouTube or, you know, begin to do Insta or something. That's a class going on, right? So in the endocrine system, what are we going to do? The thymus gland and its hormones. So whenever we start any for that matter, any organ, what do? We first see the location, right? Because it's very important to know where in our body is that organ. So thymus is what? Thymus is a small organ, and it is where it is behind the sternum. And what is the sternum in layman language? If you want to explain, it's the breastbone, right? And just for some information, this thymus gland is both involved in our immune system as well as endocrine system, right? So we will see how it works in immune system and how it works in endocrine system. In both ways, we will see it. Now, let us see what is the importance of it, right? We're just doing very basic things for first 2 minutes. Then we'll go in the deeper details so that you know what is coming in the lecture. What is the importance? The T lymphocytes. We'll do what are T lymphocytes. Don't worry. Training to fight infections and even cancer. So basically, we'll see how it is fighting against infections, and it is very important in fighting cancer even. Okay, so this is the importance of this gland in fighting of the infections. How? We will just see in another 2 minutes, right? So let us see this diagram. So as you can see that it is where it is behind this sternum in front of the heart, and these are the lungs, right? You can see that these are the lungs. This is the cardiac notch, right? And it is in between. This is the thymus that we are talking about. And if we see, we have already done the thyroid gland and we are doing the thymus. And if you can see, it is made up of two lobes, right lobe and left lobe, that is separated. And these lobes are made up of small lobules, right? And we'll do the cells that are present in these lobules. So this is the structure of the thymus gland, basically the location of the thymus gland. So now if you want to say, if I ask you to write the anatomy of thymus gland, what will you write? Let us see what can we write. Like, so it lies in the chest. The first point that we can write, it lies in the chest, right? What is the second point that we can write? It lies directly behind sternum, right? And what else can we see? It is in front of heart, right? And what else can we see? What else can we write? That is, it is present in area between lungs. So this is basically, and these 4 points, this is mostly thymus is present here. But sometimes, what happens, sometimes it is present in ectopic location. What do we mean when we say ectopic location? It means some another location besides all these that we have discussed. So where it can be in the neck region, right? And sometimes it can be in the thyroid gland, you know, above, near, adjacent to the thyroid gland. And sometimes it can be even on the surface of the lungs, right? And where on the surface of the lungs? Near the area where blood vessels and bronchi enter the lungs, right? So these are known as ectopic location. So if a question comes that can it be present in neck, thyroid, in the neck or in the thyroid, then yes, it can be present. And if a question comes, thymus is present area between lungs, in the neck, in the thyroid gland, adjacent to the thyroid gland, all of the above. So all of the above, right? Now let us see something about the shape. As we saw, it is a little pyramidical, and we say that is it is similar to you might be knowing a thyme leaf, and that's why some people say that it comes from that it is similar to the thyme leaf, and that's why the thymus name, right? And what did we saw when we were seeing the diagram? That it is made up of two lobes, and that are broken into lobes that are broken into lobules, right? So the first thing that we can say about shapes is that it is made up of two lobes that are broken into lobules. Now these lobules have one adrenal, they have one outer cortex and one inner medulla, right? Outer cortex and inner medulla. What is the outer cortex doing? It has the immature T lymphocytes. We'll do this part in detail. What is this immature T lymphocytes? And inner medulla have mature T lymphocytes. And we are going to do in detail what are these immature and mature T lymphocytes. So I guess the basic thymus gland is clear to you. Now one very important line that you should know, that thymus gland is considered, you know, very interesting, a lymphoid organ. What? It is considered as a lymphoid organ. And what is a lymphoid organ? A lymphoid organ is an organ of immune system. So we can say the thymus is considered a lymphoid organ. And can you name some other lymphoid organs we have done? We have done tonsils, adenoids, spleen, right? So basically we can say the thymus is considered a lymphoid organ. Why? We will see it in this lecture only. Why it is considered a lymphoid organ? We will see it in this lecture only. Now let us do the cells of the thymus, right? Now let us do the cells of, I hope you're writing, because making notes is very important in any subjects, right? So what are the cells of thymus? We can write the cells are epithelial cells. And what are epithelial cells? We all know now, we have done so many lectures. The cell lining, the cells, epithelial cells are the cells lining what? Body surface and cavities. We know that these are epithelial cells. And the other kind of cells, very interesting name. These are hormone producing cells. See this, we say it's Kulczewski cells, whatever, but you know, it's just because of learning of the spelling, but this pronunciation is very different, right? And the third is thymocytes. And the third one is this Kulczewski cells are named on the these cells are named on the scientist who basically discovered these cells. So hormone producing cells and the thymocytes are cells that become T lymphocytes. You might be wondering what is this T lymphocytes. I am again and again saying for kids who don't know, we'll be doing it. Don't worry. These are the major type of cells of the thymus and some dendritic cells, right? Dendritic cells and few B lymphocytes. And few B lymphocytes also are also present. And what are B lymphocytes? If I ask you, these are lymphocytes. I think you should know it. These are lymphocytes that produce what? That produce antibodies. So what are B lymphocytes that produce? Lymphocytes that produce antibodies. And interestingly, there are also some myoid cells. What are myoid cells? Whenever the term myoid, muscle-like cells, right? So now these are the cells of thymus, epithelial cells, Kulczewski cells, thymocytes. I don't know actually what is the correct pronunciation of this. Dendritic cells and few B lymphocytes and myoid cells. Now, let us see one more interesting thing. How it changes with age, right? Interesting, no? How it changes with age. Now let us see how it is changing with age. It is large in infants. In small kids, in infants, it is large. Bachcho mein hota hai ye. Magar ye puberty mein maximum size ka hota hai. Ye grow karta hai aur apni maximum size ka puberty mein reach karta hai, right? Maximums and grows and reaches to maximum size during puberty. Ab maximum size ka ho gaya, to iske baad kya hoga? Infants mein tha, it was big. Maximum pahuncha puberty mein. After puberty, what will happen? After puberty, it shrinks. Yes, it shrinks. And it is largely replaced with fat. So basically, ye khatam ho jata hai when after puberty, slowly it begins to just shrink and it's gone. Till in elderly people, it's gone. And this process that it is replaced by fat, this atrophy, where it is getting degraded or shrunk, it is known as a very important word, thymic. Thymic involution, right? This is known as thymic involution. So these are infants mein bada hota hai, puberty mein it reaches maximum, and after puberty, thymic involution takes place. Understood? Till now, no problem till now, right? We'll go slow when there is something very difficult to understand. Now let us see the function. So, as we said, that it acts as a lymphatic organ and also an endocrine organ. It acts as a lymphatic organ and also acts as an endocrine organ. So, let us first see its function as its role in immunity, right? So, first let us see its role in immunity, and then we'll see the hormones secreted, how it is acting like an endocrine organ. We'll see afterwards. So before we go into deeper detail of its role in immunity, let's distinguish between, because I'm pretty sure many of the kids don't know the difference between T lymphocytes and B lymphocytes, right? So let us distinguish between T lymphocytes and B lymphocytes. So let us first talk about T lymphocytes and then we will talk about B lymphocytes. So we can write, we will see how these T cells are formed, but let us see, first let's distinguish between them. What is the functional difference between T lymphocytes and B lymphocytes? T cells, also called T lymphocytes, also called thymus derived lymphocytes, right? So now let us see something about them. they mature in, they basically are formed in bone marrow, right? And via blood stream, what happens? They go to thymus, and where they mature into T cells, right? They mature into T cells. So bone marrow mein bane, aur jo banate hain, inko wo kehte hain progenitor cells. So progenitor cells bone marrow mein bane, bloodstream ke through thymus mein gaye, mature hue wahan aur T cells mein ban gaye, right? Now we are here. We are looking at the functional difference, right? On the functional or on the role difference. So what is the role of T cells? Very important word that you should know. They are involved in cell-mediated immunity. What is this cell-mediated immunity? That the cells-mediated, cells kar rahe hain kaam, immunity badhane mein. Immunity matlab lad rahe hain, germ se, bacteria, virus, sabse ye fight kar rahe hain. Kaun fight kar rahe hain? Cell fight kar rahe hain, cell ke through ho raha hai. So cell themselves are active. Cells themselves are active in, please write it down, in movie nahi chal rahi hai, right? In fighting of foreign invaders. Cells themselves are fighting, are active in fighting of foreign invaders. And what can be the foreign invaders? Can you name? Such as bacteria, virus, cancerous cells, and many more. So cell-mediated immunity, where the cells themselves are fighting off foreign invaders. Now, basically, hum kya padh rahe the? Aap bhool to nahi gaye, hum T cells or T lymphocytes ke functional difference kar rahe hain between B lymphocytes and T lymphocytes. So their role, T lymphocytes are involved in cell-mediated immunity, right? Now we are looking at B lymphocytes. What are they doing? They are part of, very important word that I'm going to write, and you should know this word, humoral immunity system. What is this humoral immunity system? Kai books mein ye word likha hai, but explain nahi kiya gaya hai. What is this humoral immune system, which is being a part of B lymphocyte? So this humoral immunity system is a kind of immunity system which produces antibodies directed at specific invaders, right? Abhi kaise kar raha hai? Generally, jo bhi bacteria hote hain, jo hamari body ko, ye cell hai, ye cell hai, ye extracellular space hai, right? Thoda acha sa bana lete hain. ये एक सेल है, ये एक सेल है, ये कई सारे सेल्स हैं और ये एक्स्ट्रा सेलुलर स्पेस है. सो बेसिकली क्या होता है, बेसिकली व्हाट इज हैपनिंग दैट दिस बैक्टीरिया कॉजेज इन्फेक्शन डिजीज इन ह्यूमंस, मल्टीप्लाई इन द एक्स्ट्रा, यहाँ पे ये मल्टीप्लाई करता है और उसके बाद इस सेल में चला जाता है. तो इट वुड बी वेरी नाइस अगर सॉरी इट वुड बी वेरी नाइस कि व्हेन दिस बैक्टीरिया इज मल्टीप्लाइंग ओवर हियर, वी कुछ हाई और इसको यहीं पे किल कर दे, राइट? इफ बैक्टीरिया एक्स्ट्रा सेलुलर स्पेस में किल हो जाएगा तो वो सेल के अंदर जाके इन्फेक्शियस डिजीज नहीं कर पाएगा, इट वोंट बी एबल टू डू इट. सो बेसिकली दिस इज व्हाट इज ह्यूमरल इम्यूनिटी सिस्टम. व्हाट इज इट दैट लेट अस राइट, ईच वर्ड इज इम्पॉर्टेंट, राइट? मेनी ऑफ द बैक्टीरिया दैट कॉजेज what that causes infectious disease in humans multiply where? Multiply in the extracellular space. Write it with me, in the extracellular spaces of the body, right? Extracellular spaces of the body and not intracellular. And most intracellular pathogens कैसे स्प्रेड होते हैं, हाउ डू दे स्प्रेड, दे स्प्रेड बाय मूविंग फ्रॉम सेल टू सेल, राइट, एक सेल से दूसरे सेल जा रहे हैं थ्रू दिस एक्स्ट्रा सेलुलर स्पेस, थ्रू दिस, दिस थ्रू इज वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट, थ्रू दिस एक्स्ट्रा सेलुलर स्पेस. अब अगर हम इनको यही किल कर दें, राइट, तो दीज एक्स्ट्रा सेलुलर स्पेसेस आर प्रोटेक्टेड, दीज एक्स्ट्रा सेलुलर स्पेसेस आर प्रोटेक्टेड बाय अवर ह्यूमोरल इम्यून रिस्पॉन्स, राइट. दिस इज वॉट अभी यहाँ पे आपके लिए इतना ही जानना काफी है, राइट, दिस इज प्रोटेक्टेड बाय ह्यूमोरल इम्यून रिस्पॉन्स. आई होप दिस इज क्लियर कि जो भी यहाँ मल्टीप्लाई हो रहे हैं एक्स्ट्रा सेलुलर स्पेस में, वही खत्म कर दो उनको, मतलब जला डालो, मार डालो. तो दीज आर वॉट इज इन द एक्स्ट्रा सेलुलर स्पेस, सो दैट दे आर नॉट एबल टू कॉज इन्फेक्शन बाई गोइंग इन साइड द सेल, राइट. बट हम बी लिम्फोसाइट्स के बारे में पढ़ रहे थे. सो इन विच दिस इन दिस ह्यूमोरल इम्यून रिस्पॉन्स इन विच एंटीबॉडीज प्रोड्यूस्ड बाय वॉट, प्रोड्यूस्ड बाय बी लिम्फोसाइट्स कॉज दिस डिस्ट्रक्शन, राइट, कॉज डिस्ट्रक्शन of what, cause destruction of extracellular in which antiproduce by cause destruction of these extracellular microorganisms, right, and they basically do what, they prevent intracellular infections, right, इंट्रासेलुलर इन्फेक्शंस. तो ये जो बी लिम्फोसाइट्स के जो एंटीबॉडीज हैं, जो बेसिकली हमारे जो सॉर्ड हैं, जो लड़ रहे हैं इन द एक्स्ट्रा सेलुलर स्पेस, दीज आर द एंटीबॉडीज प्रोड्यूस्ड बाय बी लिम्फोसाइट्स. तो दिस वे बी लिम्फोसाइट्स आर हेल्पिंग इन व्हाट, ह्यूमोरल इम्यून रिस्पॉन्स. चलो ये हो गया. नाउ लेट अस सी द टी ट्रेनिंग सेल ग्राउंड, right, what we were doing the role, so we were doing the role in immunity, right. So hum pehle T cell aur B lymphocytes mein distinguish kar rahe the, now we come to the role. So we were doing the role of thymus in what, in, right before me, right, I want that you write before me. Good. And now we'll do what is the role of thymus in immunity. So the first role that comes is that it acts as a T cell training ground. What do we mean by T cell training ground? Let us see. Basically, abhi humne kya padha tha? Jo immature T cells hain, what do we call the immature T cells? That are progenitor cells. Ye kahan se aa rahe hain? They are coming, they are originating where? I just told you, they originate in the bone marrow, right? They originate in the bone marrow, and these progenitor cells do what? They travel by a bloodstream and they go to the thymus, and there they mature into T cells. This we have already written, right? So now let us do some types of T cells, and then it will be very easy for you to understand this, what is T cell training ground, right? Beech mein we have to just deviate a little from the topic so that we understand our topic well. So T cells ke hum types kar lete hain, what are the types? So basically we are just doing one line about, or I can write it below. So basically we'll be doing three types of cells, three, just one line of each. So types, एक होते हैं cytotoxic cells. अब आप नाम देखो, cytotoxic cells, जो cells are directly involved for killing, right? Cells responsible for directly killing what? Infectious cells, because cytotoxic. दूसरे टाइप के सेल्स हेल्पर टी सेल्स. हेल्पर टी सेल्स ये क्या करते हैं, इनकी क्या रिस्पॉन्सिबिलिटी है? हेल्पर है तो ये बेसिकली हेल्प करेंगे. दे विल एक्टिवेट समथिंग, दे विल एक्टिवेटिंग अदर टाइप्स ऑफ टी सेल्स टू एड्रेस अ फॉरेन इन्वेडर. कोई फॉरेन इन्वेडर आया तो अदर टाइप ऑफ टी सेल्स को ये एक्टिवेट कर देंगे, राइट. एंड द थर्ड वन इज रेगुलेटरी सेल्स. व्हाट आर दीज रेगुलेटरी सेल्स? रेगुलेशन कौन रखता है हमारे सिटी में? पुलिस. तो दे आर ऑल्सो नोन एज पुलिस सेल्स. एंड दे डू वॉट? दे सप्रेस. दे सप्रेस वॉट? दे सप्रेस बोथ टी सेल्स एंड बी सेल्स. नाउ वी नो द डिफरेंस बिटवीन टी सेल्स एंड बी सेल्स. दे आर इन्वॉल्व इन सेल मीडिएटेड इम्यूनिटी एंड दे आर इन्वॉल्व इन ह्यूमरल इम्यूनिटी एंड वी नो द डिफरेंस ऑल्सो. चलो ये तो हो गई सेल टाइप की बात. साइटोटॉक्सिक सेल्स, जो सेल्स आर रिस्पॉन्सिबल डायरेक्टली किलिंग इन्फेक्शियस सेल्स. हेल्पर सेल्स क्या करते हैं? हेल्पर सेल्स क्या करते हैं? दे एक्टिवेट अदर टाइप ऑफ टी सेल्स, राइट, टू एड्रेस अ फॉरेन इन्वेडर. रेगुलेटरी सेल्स क्या करते हैं? दे सप्रेस बोथ टी सेल्स एंड बी सेल्स. आई होप यू आर राइटिंग और एल्स यू फॉरगेट एवरीथिंग आई एम टेलिंग यू. नाउ लेट अस सी समथिंग अबाउट पॉजिटिव एंड नेगेटिव सेलेक्शन. व्हाट इज दिस? यू विल कम अक्रॉस दिस वर्ड अलॉट. सो लेट अस डू दिस ऑल्सो. पॉजिटिव एंड नेगेटिव सेलेक्शन, इसका क्या मतलब होता है, राइट? पॉजिटिव एंड नेगेटिव सिलेक्शन. जो इमेच्योर टी सेल्स हैं, इमेच्योर टी सेल्स, दे कम इन द थाइमस कॉर्टेक्स, राइट. एंड बेसिकली दिस कॉर्टेक्स एक्ट्स एज अ क्लासरूम फॉर दीज इमेच्योर सेल्स. एंड व्हाट डू वी डू इन क्लासरूम? वी डू ट्रेनिंग, राइट. वी ट्रेन आवरसेल्व्स. किस चीज की ट्रेनिंग हो रही है इन इमेच्योर टी सेल्स की? व्हाट इज दिस ट्रेनिंग? सो बेसिकली दीज सेल्स आर टॉट. व्हाट दे आर टॉट? टू रिकॉग्नाइज. क्या रिकॉग्नाइज करना? टू रिकॉग्नाइज फॉरेन सेल्स, कि ये फॉरेन सेल्स हैं और ये फॉरेन सेल्स नहीं है, राइट. एंड दिस इज नोन, एंड दिस प्रोसेस इज नोन एज पॉजिटिव सेलेक्शन, राइट. क्योंकि इसमें ये पॉजिटिवली सेलेक्ट कर रहे हैं कि हाँ ये फॉरेन सेल्स हैं, राइट. वंस, अब एक बार व्हाट हैपेंस, वंस ये ट्रेनिंग इन्होंने ले ली, कहाँ पे? इन्होंने थाइमस के कॉर्टेक्स में ये ट्रेनिंग ले ली. दैट किसने? टी सेल्स ने. वंस द टी सेल्स लर्न टू रिकॉग्नाइज पैथोजन्स, अब पहला पार्ट ऑफ द ट्रेनिंग इनका कंप्लीट हो गया कि इनको पता है ये पैथोजन है. देन व्हाट डू? दे ट्रैवल टू मेडुला. एंड व्हाट डू दे डू इन मेडुला? देयर इज दिस नेगेटिव सेलेक्शन. व्हाट इज दिस नेगेटिव सेलेक्शन? इन द मेडुला व्हाट हैपेंस, दैट जो मैच्योर टी सेल्स हैं, अब वो मैच्योर हो गए क्योंकि उनको वो ट्रेंड हो गए. दे आर, अब बॉडी उनके साथ एक ट्रिक करता है, उनको इंट्रोड्यूस करता है. बॉडी इज वेरी स्मार्ट, इट इंट्रोड्यूसेस टू द बॉडीज ओन एंटीजेंस, राइट. एंड देन इट सीज क्या होता है. अब जो सेल्स बॉडी के ओन एंटीजन से रिएक्ट कर जाएंगे, these T cells, mature T cells, और उसको kill कर देंगे, उनका क्या होगा? They will be, these T cells will be eliminated. These cells will be eliminated. That which will be eliminated? Those who react with the body's own antigens. राइट. सो टी, अब इसको हम क्या कह सकते हैं? हाउ कैन वी से दैट टी सेल्स आर नेगेटिवली सेलेक्टेड फॉर ऑटो इम्यूनिटी, राइट. तो what will happen to these cells? How are they eliminated? So basically, either they die or they become regulatory cells. Mostly they die, right? Or interestingly, only 2%, khali 2% eventually make it through this positive and negative selection, right? So only 2% make it through this positive and negative selection. Chalo, itni baat to bilkul clear ho gayi. Now let us see something about the role of mature T cells. Role of mature T cells. Isme pehla hum karte hain immunity, right? Immunity, and the second we will do is autoimmunity. Immunity mein जो टी सेल्स होते हैं मैच्योर टी सेल्स उनको किस लिए ट्रेन किया गया है टी सेल्स हैव बीन ट्रेन्ड फॉर व्हाट इनको किस बात की ट्रेनिंग मिली है राइट इट बिफोर आई डू दे हैव बीन ट्रेन्ड टू रिकॉग्नाइज व्हाट टू रिकॉग्नाइज अ पर्टिकुलर एंटीजन राइट सो दे हैव बीन ट्रेन्ड टू रिकॉग्नाइज अ पर्टिकुलर एंटीजन सो व्हेन exposed to a foreign cells ab agar maan lo yahan foreign cell aa gaya to t cell kya karega foreign cell aa gaya to t cell is pe lock kar lega apne ko t cell is pe apne ko lock kar lega basically this is what I am showing this the t cell will lock to the foreign cell and what will it do it will kill it right and basically it will kill it as with the help of helper t cells and regulatory cells right to ye ho gayi immunity aur is type ki immunity ko hum kya kehte hain this type of immunity is called cell mediated immunity why cell mediated immunity because cell there is use of immune cells to fight infections राइट दैट्स वेरी कैसी टाइप की इम्यूनिटी हो गई मैच्योर टी सेल्स की सेल मीडिएटेड इम्यूनिटी बिकॉज इम्यून सेल्स आर इन्वॉल्व्ड नाउ लेट अस सी समथिंग अबाउट ऑटो इम्यूनिटी व्हाट इज दिस ऑटो इम्यूनिटी राइट जो टी सेल्स होते हैं उन वो बैरिकेटेड रहते हैं इन द कॉर्टेक्स T cells are barricaded in the cortex of thymus. Why? नहीं तो वो अपनी ही cells को differentiate नहीं कर पाएंगे और खत्म कर देंगे. Why? So that they don't kill their own cells. Right? Kill their own cells. Okay. So basically, it prevents what? It prevents autoimmune disorders. It prevents autoimmune disorders. And what are the auto? What do we mean by autoimmune disorders? When the body attacks own tissue, right? So that is autoimmune disorder. चलो इतना बात clear हो गई. उनके functions सब clear हो गए. If you have not written, you can just see and write. Autoimmunity के बारे में देख लिया हमने और हमने immunity के बारे में भी देख लिया. चलो ये हो गया. Now what I need to tell you something about the hormone production also. We have to do the hormone production. What are the hormones being produced by these glands, right? So the hormones produced are thymopoietin and thymulin. I hope that thymus gland is clear. Now हम उसके hormones कर रहे हैं. अब ये hormones क्या करेंगे? Since हमें पता है कि क्या function हो रहा है, तो hormones क्या करेंगे? ये समझना हमारे लिए आसान होगा. So ये hormones assist करेंगे जहाँ T cells are getting differentiated into different types. So basically these hormones that these are the hormones that assist in the process where T cells write with me, make notes, differentiate into different types. तो एक हार्मोन का काम हमें पता चल गया, थाइमोपोएटिन एंड थाइम्यूलिन. चलो अब दूसरे हार्मोन के बारे में भी लिख लेते हैं. दूसरा हार्मोन थाइमोसिन. What is this thymosin doing? Let us understand and let us write about it. What is this doing? It basically emphasizes the immune response, right? It basically emphasizes the as well as it does one more thing. It stimulates what? The pituitary hormone. Such as growth hormone, right? Thymosin के बारे में भी जान लिया हमने कि it is in accentuating. Basically, a good word to write here is accentuates the immune response as well as stimulates the pituitary hormones such as growth hormone. Now let us see the thymic humoral factor. Thymic humoral factor kya karega? It is first point is it is similar to thymosin. ये थाइमोसिन की तरह ही है मगर काम करता है, मगर ये इट इंक्रीजेस द इम्यून रिस्पॉन्स टू वायरसेस. ये स्पेसिफिकली जो है वायरसेस को, जो वायरस आता है तो उसके लिए ज्यादा इम्यून रिस्पॉन्स इंक्रीज करता है इन पर्टिकुलर. तो thymic humoral factor और thymosin में क्या फर्क है? Thymic humoral factor is specific to viruses, right? And thymosin is general immune response. Now we have done these hormones, thymopoietin and thymulin, that assist in the process where T cells differentiate into different types. Thymosin, that is increasing the immune response as well as it is stimulating the pituitary hormones such as growth hormone. Thymic humoral factor kya kar raha hai? Thymosin ki tarah hi kaam kar raha hai magar virus pe zyada particular hai. Chalo ye ho gaya. Ab ek topic aur kar lete hain aur hamara ye thymus khatam ho jayega. What are the disorders? So let us do the disorders and then this thymus gland will be over. So pehla disorder that we are going to do is hypoplasia or aplasia of the thymus. Ab isse to samajh mein aa hi raha hoga ki hypoplasia ya aplasia, what is this? Reduction or absence or hypoplasia matlab reduction, aplasia matlab absence of what? Of the thymus function. Or thymus function nahi hoga to kya ho jayega? And generally it is caused by gene mutation. It is generally caused by gene mutation. So basically immunity khatam ho jayegi. Autoimmune disorders badh jayenge. Theek hai? To pehla humne kiya hypoplasia aur aplasia. Second we can see is thymic follicular hyperplasia. Ab thymic follicular hyperplasia kya disorder hai? What is this? This is the enlargement of lymphoid follicles in the thymus gland, right? इसमें अभी आपको बहुत ज्यादा डिटेल में जाने की जरूरत नहीं है. जब आप एमबीबीएस एमडी करोगे तब आप आराम से पढ़ना. ट्यूमर्स हो सकते हैं. ट्यूमर्स को क्या कहते हैं? थाइमोमास. इसमें बेसिकली इट हैपेंस इन द थाइमिक epithelial cells, or these tumors can be of two types. Generally, all tumors can be of two types. What are those? There are benign and malignant. And these are, we mean non-cancerous, and malignant means cancerous, right? So these are the various disorders. And one word more that you can learn over here is thymectomy. What is thymectomy? Thymectomy is very easy, you might be knowing. It is a surgery to remove thymus gland. Surgery to remove thymus gland. Iske repercussions kya ho sakte hain? Agar ye bahut early age mein hum thymectomy karani pade, to kya ho sakta hai? To risk of autoimmune disorders बढ़ सकता है, जैसे अपने ही टिश्यू को बॉडी अटैक करने लगेगा, वो उस काइंड के डिसऑर्डर्स, रिस्क ऑफ ऑटोइम्यून डिसऑर्डर्स बहुत ज्यादा बढ़ जाते हैं, एलर्जीज बहुत सारी हो जाती हैं, राइट, बहुत सारी एलर्जीज होने लगती हैं, एस्थमा हो जाता है, विच इज ऑल्सो काइंड ऑफ, यू हैव डन एस्थमा इन डिटेल, एंड वन थिंग मोर दैट कैंसर का रिस्क भी बढ़ जाता है. Right, so guys, we have done today a lot of thing on thymus gland. This completes our thymus gland. And slowly we are doing, we have done hypothalamus, pituitary, we have done thyroid, we have done thymus, and slowly we are moving towards the more of the chapter. So today's lecture is over, and we did a lot of things today. We did what? We did thymus gland in detail. We did in a lot of detail. We did its function, we did its, not structure, yes, you can say we did its structure a little, we did its shape, and then we did the, you know, how things are happening, you know, how things are happening, and what else we did, and then we did the hormones, and then we did the disorders. So, today's class is over. Have fun, take care.